guys, welcome back to World Mechanics. In today's video, guys, we're going to show you how to recharge the AC system on Ford Fiesta MK7. This one will be, guys, generation 2009 to 2017. So if you have a Fiesta, guys, we'll be demonstrating on AC, but other Fiestas will be that way too. Very close procedure, so stay with us and let's start on it now. So outside right now it's 84 degrees. I have the AC button on, I have it on low, and let me show you out of the vents we get 84 degrees. Pretty accurate. You can see the AC is not blowing any cold air at all. So when you open the hood of your Fiesta, guys, you'll be able to find the AC label on the bumper here, and ours is 1.6 turbo GTDI. Okay, and for this one you can see we need 675 grams of Freon, which is 24 ounces US or England, and 4 ounces of oil. But about the oil, guys, okay, check it out now. I have two cans. Why? Because one is 3 ounces, but when you switch on the back side, it says that it contains only 2 ounces of oil and 1 ounce of refrigerant, which means that from the two cans we'll get 4 ounces of oil and 2 ounces of refrigerant. Each one of the refrigerant cans is 12 ounces in our case. So from one we'll need about 12 and the other one about 10. So altogether that will be about empty on the second one, just a little bit before empty. So if you feel about 2 ounces left, okay, and then we'll need to locate the low pressure side. This is high pressure, this is low pressure. We'll need to remove the cap there, okay. So we're going to use the oil now, okay. We're going to connect the first can of oil. With the engine not running, okay, just connect it and do not press the trigger. Okay, make sure it's connected. Do not press the trigger now. We need to go ahead and start the car first. So I have the car started here now. You have to have the AC switch on. You have to have it all the way on low and the fan running. That will be the first step. So now we will need to start adding, okay, the oil. So you just press on the trigger, okay, and you wait for it to take the whole oil. It might take a minute or two, maybe 3-4, depending how long it takes to take it. But you can see, we'll show you later how we can adjust the temperature and to check the pressure on the system as well. Okay, so we'll just do that, guys, and come back to it when it's empty. So the oil is empty. I would recommend to turn the engine off so you don't get your fingers around the belt, fan, or anything like that. Stay away from the fan. Now we're going to go ahead and disconnect the can, but be careful because it might always have pressure. Wear eyeglasses, eye protection, guys, because that thing can get in your face. Okay, and what we'll do next, we'll add one can of refrigerant. That way the oil will be flowing freely. Now, we'll have to use that adapter, and this is because we're in California, and you can see you either use an EPA compliant hose or a special adapter, and that adapter is very inexpensive. We will have it listed in the description of the video below. Okay, so okay, we connected it, we are ready. Now let's go ahead, plug it in, and you start emptying the system. Now it's 85 degrees outside, and check out how we can adjust the temperature on the gauge now. Okay, you can see that it has readings, and we'll set it at 85, so it'll show you where we need to be later. Now you're going to notice the compressor kicking in. Okay, you can see the compressor kicks in, and we keep adding Freon until the can is empty. It might take you longer time now. The more you put, the longer it takes. So the compressor kicks in, the fan is working, that's why you should always stay away from the fan, and we'll just go ahead and add that. So as I said, we have the temperature set right there at 85, so you can see the two lines, that's where it should stay when you release the trigger. In our case it's less than 40, but that's only the first can, so we'll need to add more. And you have to stay, guys, until the end to see how cold it will be. I guarantee you, it will be amazingly cold. So we disconnect this one again. I would recommend that you actually can go ahead and turn the engine off. Okay, this one is completely empty. Keep it away from your eyes, okay, because it can spray. So we'll go ahead and add the second can of oil. For this one, we will not require a special adapter now. Okay, we can just go ahead and add it. If you're in California, you have to use that adapter. If you're not, just forget about it. Most places, at least. Okay, connect it again and just empty the whole oil again. It will take about 2-3 minutes. So now we're ready to disconnect the oil. It might spray some out. Okay, when you add the oil, sometimes it can come out. Okay, again, be careful. You just have a little bit of pressure as much as you had in the system. It's impossible not to have any pressure at all because the system right now has about 40 pounds of pressure. And lastly, guys, we'll install the adapter and we are going to go ahead and put the second can. Now, the second can will add a little bit more than half. Okay, right there. Okay, perfect. Okay, now we're going to go ahead and add this one and we'll show you how cold it is inside. So we added a little bit more than half. We're going to disconnect it now and let's go check the temperature inside the vehicle and see if it's freezing cold now. So you can see, guys, 84 degrees still outside. I'm here now with the thermometer and we have 10 degrees Fahrenheit, even dropping, okay, right here on the vent. Okay, Celsius. Okay, let me show you what this one is. Celsius, negative 13 degrees. That's unbelievable cold. It's freezing cold. So that's how you guys do it. Thank you for watching and see you guys next time.